level.
Seems like there is some issue. Now, here as you can see, my new smart digital multimeter from Kaiweeds, model KM601. So, let's open it up. User manual. Very nice case. So, that's our multimeter. High quality cables. Batteries, extra batteries, temperature testing unit, and the meter itself. The case itself is really good. Well, this multimeter is quite rugged and looks more like a mobile phone. Here is the cover, I think it is removable. Yeah, okay. It was quite difficult to remove the cover. Sturdy look. And here we have it. Okay, so here are the connection points, and let's plug in the batteries first. Okay, I think I will have to open this point. Yeah, so these are the battery points, three batteries. It's good that they have provided us extras. Positive side, okay. So here I'm giving you the close-up, auto and function, pressing it once, DC and AC voltage mode. And it is also flashing the temperature of the environment around it right now. Next is the resistance, continuity. You see here it is written manual. Next, diode, capacitor, voltage in millivolts, both AC and DC, frequency. Next is temperature. And this is NCV. This I will tell you what it is. Current in milliamperes and amperes. If you press it again, it is going to move on to the smart mode. You see, it is going to detect automatically what kind of measurement we are doing right now. Next, here as you can see, it says flashlight. And here we have it. There are two more buttons. This is power on off, I have already shown you. And this is not a button, this is the NCV point. Now guys, here as you can see it is saying common, so black will be connected over here. Next, you see live, ohms, capacitor, diode, continuity, voltage, frequency, temperature. For this type of measurement, the red wire will be connected here. So, that's that. Now, let's say that I want to measure the voltage of this lithium-ion battery. And here we have it, 4 volts. It has automatically detected that we are measuring voltage here. Next, Let's go for manual voltage measurement. Now for manual voltage measurement, you can see that it is guiding you that you have to connect red and black wires over these points. Okay. Yeah, and again we have 3.986. Okay, I think this is going to come out. Nice. Next, I have this 1 kilo ohm resistor. Let's see its resistance. Oh, sorry, it's not in the auto mode. 987 ohms. Continuity. Diode. 6 amperes diode. Reverse bias. And here we have 0.5 volts. Next, I have this 2 kilovolts capacitor. So it is 7.5 nanofarad. Next is frequency. So here I have this 220 volts AC supply. And here, as you can see, the frequency is 50 hertz. Next, oh, we already know the temperature. It is 26 degrees. Moving on to NCV live. Now, this is what I was talking about. Let's remove the wires. So here we have the cable. Nothing. So you see, this side is neutral. I will show you. It is somewhat like this. So this is the point. Nothing. Close up. Very little beeping. And here. So this side is live and this side is neutral. So it is measuring from quite far distance. That's nice. Now let's move on to ampere measurement. So here is flashing common and tenny. Connecting one wire to the supply. Now let's connect this 12 volts bulb. So it's drawing around 2 amperes, 2.052, and same there, 2.0. So the current accuracy is quite good. And lastly, here we have this APO auto power off. Link to buy this product has been provided in the description. So I have this power supply. Here, as you can see, 4.5 volts. So that's our simple LED chaser. Let's turn off the lights. And that's the potentiometer with which we can manage the speed.